Now, this is my fifth visit to Bahrain in the last 18 months. I welcome the opportunity to be here to continue discussions of mutual interest and importance to Bahrain and the United States. Bahrain remains an important partner, ally, and friend of the United States. During my visit, I've met with senior government officials, as well as lawyers, journalists, medical professionals, human rights advocates, and members of several political societies. I've learned much about developments in Bahrain since my last visit here in February of this year. My discussions have been productive, open, lively, and reflective of the strong and long-lasting relationship between the people and governments of our two countries. My discussions with a broad cross-section of Bahrainis have focused primarily on the status of and prospects for a comprehensive political dialogue in Bahrain, as well as the process of implementing the recommendations of the BICI report. The government of Bahrain has taken some important first steps in laying the foundation for dialogue and for reconciliation. We're pleased, for instance, to see a great number of workers have been reinstated in their jobs, students back to school, and that the ICRC has been able to gain access to the prisons. While street violence has diminished to some degree, we continue to urge protesters to reject the use of Molotov cocktails and other violent attacks on police. We also urge the police to refrain from the use of excessive force. It is noteworthy that the government is engaged with the ILO in the reinstatement of workers and is compensating the victims of last year's unrest. These measures signal a commitment to addressing some of the underlying causes of the unrest, which is crucial to building trust in Bahrain. However, much remains to be done. The government of Bahrain needs to take action on the full range of other BICI recommendations that we believe will help lay the foundation for longer-term reform and reconciliation. This includes prosecuting those officials responsible for the violations identified in the BICI report, dropping charges against all persons accused of offenses involving political expression, including freedom of assembly, and ensuring fair and expeditious trials in appeals cases. It also means continuing to work to professionalize and diversify Bahrain's security forces to reflect the communities which they serve. Working to implement the recommendations of the BICI in an inclusive way will enhance trust and create the space for dialogue and reconciliation. Today, an appeals court in Bahrain upheld the convictions of 9 medics and acquitted 9 others associated with protests last year at the Salmania Medical Complex. While sentences were reduced, we are deeply disappointed by these convictions and that the Bahraini government did not use alternative means to address these cases. As we've said in the past, these convictions appear to be based, at least in part, on the defendants' criticisms of government actions and policies. The defendants are appealing these convictions to the Court of Cassation. We urge an expedited review of these convictions and that the medics will be allowed to remain at home pending appeal. We hope that this review will result in a dismissal of criminal charges in the interest of turning the page on the events of the last year and repairing the social fabric of Bahrain. Above all, we continue to call on all parties in Bahrain to help each other move towards a comprehensive political dialogue that includes the diverse views of Bahraini society in a genuine negotiation. Progress towards such a dialogue has slowed, polarization in Bahrain society has increased, and the social fabric has frayed. Dialogue has never been more urgent. It will take courage and leadership on all sides to bring Bahrainis of all backgrounds and views to the table. We believe dialogue is needed on two tracks. First, the government should continue to work with opposition political societies on negotiation of the political future of the country. Secondly, there is a need for dialogue on issues of practical importance to all Bahrainis that enhances the sense of all people in this society that they have a stake in the country's future. We call on the government and others in the society to seek creative and inclusive approaches to dialogue and negotiation. This process will take time, as Bahrain's friend and partner, the United States, stands ready to support you.